Okay, well, if you're having a dinner party, it's kind of hard to digest coast to coast. You know what I'm talking about? Okay, so here we go.
What kind of dinner party are you having during coast to coast hours?
Getting real weird.
No, you're in bed.
Welcome to 3 a.m., everybody. We'll now be eating the ossobuco.
You know, I had a really great idea a couple of years back. After I had kids, I realized it's really hard to get out of the house and see your friends. And so I was going to start a midnight mom's club where we all snuck out of the house at midnight and hung out. And I still think that that's the best, because that's when I do have time to hang out, you know, when my house is sleeping. Okay, let's do brew it, pour it, sip it. Everybody else brewed it, poured it, and we're going to sip it today because I'm lazy and it's the day after Christmas. So another day, I'll brew it myself. But today I had four local, but not all of them being only local coffee shops. Okay. Brew us Americanos, which is their espresso shot with a little bit of hot water. So we're still getting exactly how it tastes. I've already ranked mine. And how are you feeling about... There's one that's noticeably lighter.
Yes, very noticeable.
Very. Like, almost as if they made it incorrectly. Like, almost as if they took drip coffee and poured water into it.
It looks like there's a scoop missing from
it. Yeah, it does. Mm-hmm.
I have ruled one as my least favorite for sure.
The light one is my least favorite.
Okay. I'm not there.
Really? Okay. So the lightest.
There's nothing in these cups other than coffee.
Right.
Like, there's no cream.
Do you want to try
some? Sugar. No, thank you.
Would you like to try my favorite?
It smells amazing in here right now. But the last thing I want to do is to drink the black water that's sitting in all those cups because
these are
bitter and disgusting to me.
Yeah. These are. Okay. You guys can stay out of it. No one asked. Okay. Disgusting.
Observe, witness the greatness of these Americanas.
Okay. Americano. Okay. It's just espresso with water, with hot water. Mm-hmm. And I clearly, there's one that is.
I keep moving one up my line.
Me too. I have one at the top.
Okay.
I have one at the top.
I want to know, like, let's start with Tyler. Okay. Know what Tyler's top is.
Do you have yours in order?
Can I take a few more sips?
Here's what I'll say, is that you expect it to be, like, as you were alluding to, JG, and you expect it to be a little bit bitter. You want that little bit of bitter taste. And I guess it's for every palate to decide how bitter you want it. I like a little bit of smoothness. Mm-hmm. I don't like all bitter. I want some smoothness to mine. And so I found one that is the smoothest to my palate.
Okay.
And then they sort of get bitter, but then I had to put the lightest roast at the end for me, or the lightest, I don't know what you call it. Like the lightest.
Like in color.
And in taste.
Okay.
It's a little too watery for me.
One and the same, I think. Yes. Yeah.
And I'm going to put that at the bottom of my list. Are you ready?
I am. I think so.
Okay.
I'm diving in.
Okay.
Number one, or are we going backwards?
Should we go?
I think you start with the top.
Start at the best. Oh, I am surprised at my number one.
I really am too.
I picked Dunn Brothers.
I picked Starbucks.
Oh!
And you know, Starbucks.
Because if I would have told you which four, you would have put Starbucks at the bottom. You would have assumed that you hated it. You always say that you hate Starbucks.
Here's my excuse. It's chilled. It's room temp.
But that means it would be even better if it was warm and you know it. Okay, number two. Who's your number two?
Dunn Brothers.
See? Mm-hmm. My number two, surprisingly enough, is Caribou.
Oh.
My number three is Starbucks.
I can't read this one.
Is it RR?
Oh, yeah.
It's Red River Coffee.
Oh, okay.
Is number three for you?
I had it in the third one, but it's
have Caribou at the end.
And
Caribou
is my stuff. My That's
God.
My jam. I don't...
Tyler claims to be a Caribou guy. That Caribou is his jam. He loves Caribou so much that is his place. And now you just decided Caribou is last and Starbucks is first in the taste test. Ouch. That is a rude awakening.
Welcome to 37, where all of your expectations of who you are
get shattered. Your taste buds are changing.
Your taste buds are changing.
Red onions come next.
This is interesting because Amy goes in order of best to worst, Dunn Brothers, Caribou, Starbucks, Red River. And then Tyler goes Starbucks, Dunn Brothers, Red River, Caribou. You didn't line up on any of these.
No, we didn't.
Both number three with a bullet.
Interesting.
We finally found something. that we can use that and we say can we differ. Are not.
We are not the same about this. We are this not is, the same about
I've this. I've convinced myself that the fourth one's really good now.
You're trying to convince yourself because you know it's your it's your quote unquote favorite.
I'm coming back, Caribou. I will never leave you.
No, we're. I mean, here's the deal. We're gonna frequent all of them. These, no matter what. But it's just interesting to take because I don't think Americano is actually your go-to either. You usually just get a drip coffee, right?
Correct.
Yeah. So an Americano is different in that it's not a typical order, but it's really taking that espresso shot and putting it at the forefront.
So what should I expect between 2 and 5 as far as the caffeine intake I have
I have
Is this going to be a rocket ship between?
You want to stay awake for your birthday, don't you?
Well, yeah. I mean, for the show, I want to entertain as well as best I can the day after Christmas.
You're going to be bouncing off the walls now.
Would you like to know a little history of the term Americano?
Sure.
Okay. So Americano means American in Italian, Spanish, and Portuguese.
Thank you for that.
I did remember that from Spanish. 6 years of it.
Some assert the term entered the English language from the Italian language in the 1970s. Cafe Americano specifically is Italian for American coffee, and there's a popular belief that the name has its origins in World War II when American GIs in Italy diluted espresso with hot water to approximate the coffee that they were accustomed to back home.
Mm-hmm.
Which would be, you know,
very good.
It's just a fun, maybe we should do drip coffee next. Get a drip from each of these places and see how they shake out as compared to their Americano.
It is,
because it is different.
Mm-hmm. Totally your segment, but may I suggest?
Yeah.
Instant coffee.
Yes.
Because somebody brought me an instant coffee.
They're good. They are.
I'm not convinced.
The Starbucks one?
No, the coffee that you take a scoop out of a tin can and you throw it in some hot water. That's it.
I've got those little Via packs. Is that what they're called? Like the Starbucks one?
Yeah.
Where it's almost like you'd make a lemonade, but you make
I bet if we go to the break room right now, the person that gave me that 2 years ago, it's still here, I bet. It doesn't get old.
No one's trying it.
It's so fresh. When I think of instant coffee, I think of that SNL sketch with Chris Farley where it's like a hidden camera commercial and they're like, did you know you're drinking like decaffeinated coffee crystals? And he completely freaks out and trashes that restaurant. Yeah. It's a great little moment.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm curious to know, is Americano a go-to for you when you're, or is it just, it's a universal coffee? You're going to find it everywhere.
If I want a fresh coffee, like, you know that they're making those Americanos fresh every time because they're using a shot of espresso. So if I want a really dark, fresh cup of coffee, an Americano with a little bit of cream is a go-to. I didn't put any cream in these because we're trying to test the flavors of the coffee, right? I have to be in the mood, right? It's kind of a mood thing. Do you order Americanos a lot?
I get either that medium or light roast, whatever's there. Basic coffee. I'm a basic boy, pretty much, when it comes to coffee.
I knew
coffee.
What you were wanting to say. Yeah. I got you.
Okay. It's a family-friendly show, right?
Thank you.
And as the non-coffee drinker, let me ask you this. Uh-huh. If you're going to get something like an Americano, which, like you said, kind of leans into the bitterness a little bit, you don't get a big size one, right? Like, you'd enjoy this in a smaller batch?
I think you could go either way. But yeah, I would want it to be a smaller cup of coffee.
Because I think of an espresso and I think of the little tiny espresso cup, right? Like, no one's ordering that in the venti size.
Right.
If they are.
They're Pedro Pascal.
Right.
But,
I was going to say, like, I hope that your 15 miles that you ran today.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
Because it lingers a little bit.
It does.
In the back,
yeah. I mean, it's a stronger coffee. It's more of the espresso shot. So, but this was fun. I liked having to do a lot of the work. I just drove around and let other people do it. That was fun.
It worked out well.
It did work out well.